Hey guys, welcome to electronicsinnovation.com. In this tutorial, we are going to take a quick look at ESP32 CAM module. Later, we will see a streaming example with different pixel configurations. And then, we will look at face detection and face recognition. Here, the particular person will be recognized and the other intruders are recognized and given an alert. So, without wasting time, let's get started. In an increasingly digital world, protecting confidential information is being more difficult. Passwords or pins are not enough to secure our information. To fulfill this requirement, biometrics are coming into the picture. Biometrics is a unique identity for the human being. The biometrics like finger scan, iris scan, or face recognition are unique. A tampering machine secured or protected with these biometrics is almost impossible. What is face recognition? Identifying an individual by comparing the live capture with the stored record of that person. The ESP32 CAM is very small camera module with ESP32S chip that costs less than $10. Besides the OV2640 camera and several GPIOs are there to connect with the peripherals. This ESP32 is having a 802.11 BGN Wi-Fi BT SoC module. It is also having a 32-bit low-power CPU. It is having a 160 MHz clock speed. It is also having a built-in 520 KB SRAM and external 4 MP SRAM. It supports serial communication like UART, SPI, I2C and pulse width modulation. And it also supports ADC and DAC. This ESP32 also features a micro SD card slot that can be useful to store images taken with the camera or store file to serve clients. This ESP32 CAM module supports OV2640 and OV7670 camera modules. It is also having a built-in flash lamp for taking clear pictures. The ESP32 CAM doesn't have any onboard USB connector like NodeMCU. The NodeMCU comes with an onboard micro USB connector as shown here. But this ESP32 CAM doesn't have any provision for that. So you need a FDDI programmer to upload the code through U0R and U0T pins. These are serial pins. So now interface the FDDI module with ESP32 CAM module. Follow the connections in the schematic. Once the connection with FDDI programmer and ESP32 camera is completed, now take one female-to-female jumper wire and short the IO0 and ground pins. Now open Arduino IDE, go to the boards manager and check whether the ESP32 module add-on is installed or not. If it is installed, if you type ESP32, it will come like this and it will show it is installed. If you haven't installed the ESP32 add-on, you can simply follow the following video that I have made previously and get that installed. Now come back to the board and select for ESP32 Vroover module. Go to the file, examples and ESP32. Find the ESP32 and go to the camera and open the camera web server example. So here is the example program that we will use in this application. Now we need to make some changes in this code according to our module and requirement. In my case, my camera module is AI Thinker. Uncommenting this. Now provide your SSID and password in these fields. And this is the serial baud rate we are using. come here and go to the tools and check the ESP32 is selected and the upload speed is also selected, and check the partition scheme is Fuse App 3MB No OTA and 1MB SPI FFS option. And then select the port. Now click on the upload button. Once the uploading is done, it will show hard resetting via RTC pin. This means after the uploading code, it will reset the ESP32 module. It's a new feature in Arduino IDE version more than 1.8. Now remove the connection of IO0 and ground and click on RST button. Now come back to Arduino IDE and open serial monitor. In the serial monitor, it will show Wi-Fi is connected and also camera module is ready. Use the HTTP some IP to connect. So copy this IP and paste it in the browser. This page will load. So these are the resolution, and check for QVGA 320 by 240 for better streaming. Scroll down and click on start stream button. Immediately you will see the camera module is active. You will be able to see the output of the camera module in your laptop. You can go for a different resolutions like this. If you observe here, if we go for a higher resolution, the streaming is little bit stucky. Use 320 by 240 and scroll down, and here you will find a two option called face detection and face recognition. Enable both the options and click on enroll face. It will take 5 samples of your face and store it into the database. Later, it will start comparing your face with the previously stored face. So if it is matching, it will say hello subject 0. You can also edit in the code with the name. If any other person comes into the shot, it will detect that person is not trained, or it will treat as a intruder and it will gives an alert. So this is how we can do the face recognition of a person with a simple ESP32 CAM with a less cost. Thank you for watching.